Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to day two of our training. My name is Micah Akati, and this is what we're going to be discussing today. In today's video, we're going to look at what it takes to develop a marketing strategy. We'll look at a practical example, and then we also look at what it takes to understand the various social media platforms in terms of the tools and then the tactics to use when marketing on those platforms. Let's jump right into it. So as usual, I'll start with a tip. When you're learning something new, that's the start of a new journey. So in order for you to get to your destination, you need to work hard to master that skill, and you definitely get to where you want to get to. All right, so what is a marketing strategy? It's just basically a document that outlines action points which you need to take in order to market a product or a service to a target audience via social media. All right, so like we discussed in our previous video, before you build or you develop a marketing strategy, the four W's are going to be applied. You need to understand what you're marketing, or what the client you are serving, or if it's your own product, you need to understand what you're marketing very well. Understand the product or service very well before you develop a marketing strategy. You need to understand who you're marketing to, your demographic, your target audience, what platforms are they on, what type of things are they looking out for online. For instance, if you're marketing a new clothing or apparel to people online, then you want to find yourself on platforms that support content around apparel like Pinterest, Instagram, and possibly even TikTok for videos around clothing and all stuff like that. And you also need to understand why you're marketing that particular product. You know, so are you helping grow a new brand or product, or are you helping market a service? You need to understand. And you also need to understand which platforms are suitable for marketing what you're marketing. And that's what we're going to look at next. When you're developing a strategy, you don't want to throw in every social media platform. Just because it's available there doesn't mean you need to use that to market. Remember, the goal of marketing is for you to be able to convert, so to result in sales or signups or any of those things. But you want to be able to convert when you market. There should be tangible results. Okay, so we'll take a quick look, or we'll hop into a practical example. I'll walk you through a few platforms. So first, we're going to take a quick look at TikTok. All right, so let me just go to the For You page. Now, TikTok is a great platform that is growing really, really quickly, mainly because of the potential for your content to go viral. And that has the potential to catapult your page or your brand or your business or your product or service to the next level. We are going to do a deep dive into TikTok, but ideally, TikTok is great for brands that want to connect with people in a very organic way and grow their brand organically. TikTok relies heavily on your creativity. Now, the head of marketing for TikTok once said that don't try to create marketing videos on TikTok. Rather, you want to actually create a TikTok that people actually enjoy, that ends up marketing your products. So you don't want to go in necessarily trying to be don't create marketing videos, but create TikToks that market. So that's what he said. So that's one thing you want to consider. Now, for TikTok, even though hashtags work, like for instance, social media marketing, hashtags work, you could also just search a title within the video that you're looking for. And TikTok is very good at pulling out text from videos to help you find the content you're looking for. So that's something to keep in mind when picking a platform. Let's hop straight onto Pinterest. Sorry, let's go onto the home page. All right, I'll just scroll past these. All right, let's do a search. Let's see, social media marketing. Okay, so with Pinterest, it's a bit more tricky, but you still have some related results. Now, Pinterest is also ideal for tips, tricks, and all of those things. It's also ideal for products that showcase like clothing, fashion, and stuff like that. So Pinterest is very good at that. Even interior decor. Pinterest is a good place to find interesting content like this. But you need to really understand your customer's brand. If they're trying to get conversions, it takes a while on with Pinterest unless you're running ads. Okay, let's quickly hop on to YouTube. YouTube, as the platform already describes, is great for long format content. So let me skip from all of this. So if I were to do a search for, let's say, buy clothes, I would find long format content around the things I want to buy, possibly with links in the description to be able to go ahead and then get information on the brand that I'm looking for. So you can see here that there's Zara clothes and all that stuff. So when you want to decide on what platforms to use, you need to, like I said, the four W's: understand what you're selling. If what you're selling requires that you give some insight or some look and feel to it, especially in this age where a lot of stuff is being done online, you know, you want to see which platforms will work. We'll look at YouTube ads and Google ads in the subsequent videos, but this is just to guide you in picking a platform to work with. Let's take a quick look at Facebook. Facebook, on the other hand, is one of the most powerful tools you can use for marketing. I just realized that I've switched from the marketing plan to the various marketing platforms, but whichever way, you need to understand this also before you include them in your marketing plan. So we'll look at a practical marketing plan after this. All right, so Facebook is also a very great platform to market your products and services, mainly because it has one of the largest and most advanced databases or data around its users, and has the largest user, one of the largest user bases anyway. So we'll dive deep into the Facebook ecosystem. But Facebook is great for video, good for all-round images, good for marketing, and recently even audio, and good for integrating your sales with WhatsApp and all that. So we'll look at that when we dive into the practicalities, where we create a new page and all those things and connect things up and all that. Twitter, on the other hand, is great for links, for updates, quick updates, good for keeping abreast with what's happening, you know, within your demographic, and hopping onto conversations which could potentially make your brand go viral or make your brand do very well. So there's Twitter as well, which we'll also look at some more in subsequent videos. And then there's LinkedIn. LinkedIn is also a great place to create pages and, you know, put out your services, your products, build out your page, you know, share content with people that, you know, would value that content. So LinkedIn is a very good place. Even though you have a lot more professionals on there, it's a very great place also, depending on what product or service you are offering. Like I said, we'll dive deep into setting all these things up. This is just for us to consider when working on our strategy document. All right, so lastly is Instagram. Instagram needs no introduction. Great for reels, great for video, great for stories, great for messaging, DMs, and all that also. So it's a great place to actually build a brand as well. They also have a lot of data, a lot of users. All right, so let's take a practical look at a sample document, strategy document I prepared for a friend. Okay, so here's the document. Visual Delight is my social and digital media agency. So let's have a quick look. So the name of my friend's podcast is the Mashup 233 podcast. You can feel free to check it out. Very interesting conversations. So like I said before, when preparing the document, you know, you want to be able to understand what the product is, what the product is, who they're marketing to, where to market it, and how, you know, what platforms to use. So for this, I outlined a strategy or roadmap for them, you know, that's overall, you know, so go from taking the audio, repurposing the audio, engaging the audience, advertising, and then monetization. And I recommended these particular platforms for them because they wanted to reach a wider audience and be on as many platforms as possible. So that was a specific request. Yes, but then I think I narrowed down to these particular platforms though, because I felt like these ones would give them the best return on investment. So YouTube, which is great for long format content, and since they're doing podcasts, is great. TikTok, because they could do short videos, snippets from the podcast, which could go viral. Instagram, because they could do live interactions with their audience, and also recently Reels. And then these other ones, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, like I mentioned earlier, they could run ads on these platforms to help grow their audience as well. And in terms of the strategy would be to be consistent, you know, and then continuously create the content and to engage their community a lot, because with podcasts, you want to be close to your audience as much as possible. So with the TikTok strategy, the idea was to be able to post a couple of times a week, have some of their videos animated, and then be able to put that up, and then also do some live interactions with their audiences, and then hopping on trending audio on TikTok, because that helps your content also reach a wider audience, and then also partnering with TikTok influencers to help them with the podcast. I am going to make this document available if you're part of the WhatsApp group. This is a very, very stripped down or simplified sample of a social media strategy document. I have a few that are some between 15 to 20 pages, but in order not to let you feel overwhelmed since you're just starting, this is quite simplified. Just you go with the 4 W's approach and you're likely to be fine. So to wrap up, I'll head back to the previous presentation. One thing you need to understand about these platforms is that every social media platform has a preferred content format. For Instagram, Reels are the forefront of things now, and that's where a lot of your growth is going to happen. Or that's one way that you'd be able to market your content. And you also need to know, based on the 4 W's, which platform will have the audience that you are looking for. And then lastly, you need to understand your growth tactic. For instance, with TikTok, you want to hop on trends, you want to create very interesting, engaging videos. With Instagram, you want to take advantage of Reels and stories and long format videos. With other platforms, with Twitter, you want to hop on conversations, you want to hop on what's relevant now, and take advantage of all of those things. So just as I walk through all the platforms, I would go do a deep dive into each of them and the various tools and marketing tools that they have. We'll look at the ads manager for all of them. We'll look dive into Google Ads as well. We'll look at TikTok ads. We'll look at Pinterest ads. I mean, some of them are restricted, but the ones that we can have access to, we'll look at them and then we'll build on from there. So yes, I've taken us through the example already. So hopefully I'll wrap up on day 2 here. and I'm trying to keep these videos very short and brief and concise. If you're not clear on anything, if you felt like you need more information on certain things, let me know. Please make sure to click the link in the description to join the WhatsApp group, because I'll be posting the documents and other stuff there for you to look at later on. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please do well to do so, and leave a like if you enjoyed this content. Thank you.